Good morning, everybody. Let me show you what we got going on this morning. You might notice the air conditioner is not on. It is still uncommonly cool. It was 68 degrees this morning. For the first week of August, this is not normal, but it's okay with me. Now, Garski and Sheath, I'll show you that in a little while. It's going to work this time. I just got to do some sewing on it and this and that. Now, y'all remember this material that I work with, make bait knives out of? Make some paring knives out of this. And I'm going to this for fillet knives. And I got a new design I'll show you in a few days. Remember I told you I cannot drill this stuff. I can't find a drill bit that will drill it. Or I can drill one hole and burn the bit up. I have done a bunch of YouTube watching, talking to a couple of machinists, and I figured out how to do it. I had to hand punch them with heat and hand punch. The problem is I cannot find a punch. Let me show you one. What I can find is these here, because I use primarily 1/8-inch pins. These are those from Harbor Freight. They're too flimsy. This is a good punch here. Pardon me, but it's a little bit big and it's too short. Now when that gets good and hot, my hand is way too close to it. I'll show you like that. My hand's too close to it. So I brainstormed. I do that every now and then. And this is an old drill bit. It was an old masonry bit. I mean old, old, old. I think when they first come out with the carbide tips. I couldn't grind that off. I had to cut the end of it off. And I'm grinding it down on my little sander here. Got a gauge. When I get to the proper diameter, I'll put a sharp point on it and heat treat it. And it's long enough where I can work with it. Pardon me. Dang, coughing. But if this works good, I've got two more of these. Because there's a couple more sizes that I use pins sometimes. And I'll make those up right quick while I'm waiting on this. Some more glue to dry on the skin over here, and we'll see that in a little while. Then I can get back to work on these paring knives. All right, see you in a little while. All right, y'all, let's finish up for today. Get the camera straight here. Now, I have monkeyed with this thing for 3 days. Most all day today. But I think I about got it did. The big Garski and Sheath. There we go. And I had to split the skin here to expose that spine, but nothing I can do about it. That's all the Garski I have. I don't have any more. There's the back. Now this strap here snapped in. Now this young man wanted a cross carry option, but that's what that's for. Now this one here, I've got another one to go up through here, and I'm also going to snap in, but I've got to wait till tomorrow when I go to town and get some more snaps. I just bought a big package of snaps not long ago, and as I mentioned on video, and I cannot find them. I spent an hour looking through the bench and everything. I don't know what happened to them. They're here somewhere, but anyway, that's what that's for. Plus, you'll have your, like a Molly strap there. You can hang something on there if you want to.
knife fits in there real nice. I'm going to clean this up and sharpen it before I send it back to you. And there you go. I hope you like it. I'll probably put one more. It's got three coats of finish on it now. I'll probably put one more on there just to make sure it's sealed up real good. Alright, and I did it black because the handle's black. The original sheath was black. And there we go. There's that. That thing is giving me a fit. I'm telling you. And you are getting the better end of that deal, I promise you. But that's okay. Can I show y'all my little tool that I finished? There's my little punch. I was going to try it out today. Looks like I'm going to have to wait till tomorrow, too. I got the little pair of knives cut out. And see, Gary, William, Darius, I already showed you yours. Paul, this is the new fillet knife design, just for you. It's still rough, I haven't ground it yet. Got it cut out, but I haven't ground. This is, you want a 10-inch blade? That's a big blade, man. Sneak peek, that's enough. this one is forged out of a file. It's going to be a neck knife out of an old file, one I worked on several videos back. This one was due to go to somebody a long time ago, and quite honestly, would you, my friend, I forgot. So I'll get that in the next couple of days also. Now look at this little jewel here. Still working on it. This is that lady's knife I showed you. Got it ground. Pretty much I gotta etch it, blade etch it, and heat treat it. But I cut these serrations in there. Those are all hand cut. And I've also added a finger guard. It'll go down here like that. And once the handle's on there, I'll round it just so when, if you do have to use it, your hand won't, your fingers won't slip onto the blade. And I'll figure out how to get that incorporated in the sheath work. It won't be in the way. So that's all we got for today. It is quitting time. I got to go in and get cleaned up. We're supposed to go to town this morning. My mama didn't want to go this morning. So now she wants to go this afternoon. So I do what I'm told. So. And that's all there is to that. So I'll show y'all maybe some of these finished up tomorrow or some more in progress. The last video, I knew it was going to happen. Doggone, that's why I almost didn't say anything. I'm not singling out anybody. If you've got a knife ordered from me, I'm not talking about you. Any of these on the table, it's somebody, a whole different deal. So I'm not singling out nobody. If you're who I'm talking about, you've already got an email from me, so that's that. We'll leave it at that. All right, thank y'all for watching. Thank you for your support. And I will see y'all tomorrow, maybe the next day.